Ever wondered what stuff looks like close up? I mean, really close up? Most people use a light and a lens to magnify things.
But when it comes to getting up really close, looking through glass just doesn't cut it.
So today, we look at how scientists harness the power of electrons to get up really close.
This is Joel and we're in the scanning electron microscope room. Can you tell us a bit about this machine?
Yes, this is the scanning electron microscope. It works by focusing a beam of electrons down the column. This beam of electrons is then rastered across the sample that you're looking at, and the image is shown on a TV screen.
How powerful is this machine?
It has a resolution of 4 to 5 nanometers, which is very small.
The electron microscope resolves down to a few nanometers. That's 1,000,000,000 times smaller than a meter.
Now, as well as the scanning electron microscope, which bounces electrons off a sample, scientists also use what's called the transmission electron microscope. So what's the difference?
The main difference is that with the transmission microscope, you've got the electrons passing straight through the sample. So the sample has to be extremely thin. The reason for this is that we can get internal structural information from a sample, and also it has much higher resolving power than a scanning electron microscope as well.
So what sort of projects would you be involved in then?
We look at the material's microstructure, work out the shape of the material on a small scale.
What are we looking at here?
This is the inside of an eggshell. And what we're looking at is a secondary electron image. What it does is the electrons coming down the column interact with the sample, and they knock off other electrons from within that sample. And then these are picked up in a detector which sits just about there, and then they're shown on the screen. This is a broken off paper clip. So it's made out of iron or some sort of steel. What we've got is the fracture surface of a paperclip here, and there's a piece of dust sitting on there. Now, if we change to what's called backscattered electron imaging, the piece of dust is quite dark, whereas the metal is quite bright.
Do you love your job?
Yeah, I do love my job, yes. The best part about my job would be just the variety of materials I look at, and just things that no one's ever seen before, very small, you know, things that no one can look at with their eyes.